greetings. I recently came across an interesting, and new to me, sliver of Christianity. Red letter Christianity. It sounded dedicated and serious and committed, so I decided to research it and make this video. Preparing for this video, I decided to Google Red Letter Christian. And slap me silly, they've got a wiki page. They've even got an organization and a web page. And they have got to be serious, because their website says it right there at the top. Red Letter Christians, taking the words of Jesus seriously. So why did I call this video Red Words Matter? I phrase it that way to borrow from the error and style of Black Lives Matter. If your knee-jerk reaction to that was, "That's racist," you need to watch my video. The truth has no skin color. Notice my intentional choice of color in each font. Red and yellow, black and white. I believe Yeshua the Messiah died for every person on earth, whatever their skin color. I phrase it that way to borrow from the error and style of Black Lives Matter, because my answer to both would be the same. All lives matter. All words matter in the scriptures. When one specifies only part of the whole, one explicitly excludes the rest of the whole. It is an act of intentional omission to focus the rhetoric selectively. This is where Red Words Matter leaves the path of truth. And I believe it will be obvious for those with eyes to see if the Holy Spirit is not already flooding your mind with scriptures. Succinctly, it boils down to the following statement. One should believe Jesus' words in red over Paul's words in black. I know, it leaves me stunned and my mouth hanging open. It was honestly hard to even know where to begin to address this position. And at first, I had thought the poster who raised it was a lone troll, because it was coupled with a strange Judaizer theme. Christ was prophesied of from the Jewish scriptures. Christ was born a Jew. Christ was raised a Jew. Christ followed the Jewish teachings. Christ as well died a Jew. Christ was buried a Jew. And Christ rose again as a Jew. Christ never renounced being Jewish. Okay. Sadly, those are non sequiturs, unrelated to the salient points. And it attacks an erroneous straw man that Jesus was somehow Christian or Catholic or some other denomination. The simple and obvious answer being that Jesus was the prophet of Deuteronomy 18, promised by God from Israel, sent to Israel. Matthew 15:24, Jesus speaking, "But he answered and said," and these are in red letters, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." There is no doubt that Yeshua is the Jewish Messiah. No Christian should be ignorant of the Jewish basis of Christianity. It is one reason the Jewish scriptures, the Torah and Tanakh, are included in the Bible as the Old Testament. But the error of replacement theology has cursed many denominations into ignorant darkness. Matthew 15:24, Jesus speaking, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." No, his Jewishness was clouded, beginning with calling him Jesus and not Yeshua. Paul, also coincidentally a Jew, was sent by this same Jesus, Yeshua, to preach the gospel to the Gentiles, speaking to Ananias in Damascus, This same Jesus, Yeshua, said to Ananias in Acts 9:15, "Go," said the Lord. "This man," speaking of Paul, "is my chosen instrument to carry my name before the Gentiles and their kings, and before the people of Israel." And to Paul, this same Jesus, Yeshua, gave the following command. Acts 18:19. One night the Lord spoke to Paul in a vision. "Do not be afraid. Keep on speaking. Do not be silent." Stated simply, the red letters of Jesus authorize the black letters of Paul. There is no conflict, no hierarchy, no issue, if you really take the words of Jesus in red seriously. If someone actually bothers to read and study and think about the role Jesus played and the role Paul played. But that only examines the error from the perspective of Jesus' words versus Paul's words. And no doubt the minds of red-letter Christians hear the following arguments in their heads. Well, Jesus was God. Obviously, Jesus had direct communication with God. Jesus could not get it wrong. But Paul was just a man. He could easily get it wrong. No man hears God perfectly. Or other words to that effect. Red letter followers seem to incorporate the concept of Jesus' deity as the trump card. And I'm sure I just triggered a few using the word Trump, 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 Trump. But another issue remains. Something else that Jesus said, which should be in red letters. John 16:12. "I," this is Jesus speaking, "I," that's why it's in red, "I have many more things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now." So how could a red letterist possibly read and integrate that into their dogma? "I have many more things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now." All of those in red. Jesus declares, Jesus says, it's in red, there are some things he cannot say right then. They cannot appear in red letters. But when he, the Spirit of truth, comes, he will guide you into all the truth. For he will not speak on his own initiative, but whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will disclose to you what is to come. How can a red letterist possibly integrate the Holy Spirit into their thinking? His words can never be written by himself, let alone be colored in red. His message must be given through inspiration through apostles and disciples and believers. And his words can never, ever, ever be colored in red, 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 red. And yet Jesus, the Messiah, who they claim to follow more seriously, that Jesus said to listen to and follow the Holy Spirit. Red letterism must therefore diminish, if not dismiss, the Holy Spirit's role in Christians' lives. That's bad any way you color it. Simply from doctrinal examination, this red letter crap is, well, crap. In and of itself, I do not think it is a damning error, but where it leads and how it manifests is actually very dangerous. The website manifests the lawlessness of this age in the socialist gospel. However, it creates a dilemma which might lead one back to the truth. Just like the Islamic dilemma, which can lead serious people out of Islam. The Islamic dilemma is that the Quran endorses the contents of the Bible we have today, but the contents of the Bible disprove the Quran. So if the Quran has any truth in it about the Bible, the rest of the Quran must be false. Likewise, the red letter dilemma is that the red letters are ultimately authoritative, but the red letters authorize and authenticate the rest of the letters in black. So one cannot respect the red letters and then dismiss and disregard the black letters. To do so disproves the claim of taking the red words seriously. And while I will not go too far down this path, the website proves red letterism is only a front. It is a socialist agenda site against rule of law, and therefore will align with the man of lawlessness when he comes. Ultimately, red letterism exhibits similarity to every other deception Satan has used, is using, and will use. Has God said? From the garden onward, Satan's chief tool is deception and shaking your hold on the Word of God. Islam's fraud and deception is partly that Yahweh God is impotent to preserve His Word. Has God said? The error of liberal Christian denominations that everything is metaphor and symbology. Has God said? The denial that God is able to form coherent sentences and actually mean what He revealed for the prophets to say? What makes someone fall for such an error? What opens them to this deception? Well, we must first honestly acknowledge the appeal. Following Jesus. Who among us, what Christian, wants to say, "I do not follow Jesus"? That is what makes Satan's lies so brilliant in their effectiveness. For example, the lie of Islam, that everyone who submits to God is, by definition, a Muslim. Or to follow Jesus, you must first respect what Jesus said, as indicated by the color of the ink. So, only respect what Jesus said in the red words. After all, every Christian wants to follow Jesus. But not every Christian knows they need to study to show themselves approved unto God, a workman that does not need to be ashamed. 2 Timothy 2:15, study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. This is where the denominational bureaucracies have failed Christ and failed Christians. They have not fed the sheep the milk of the word and then the meat of the word. This is not a matter of earning your salvation in any way. It is desiring the sincere milk of the word so that you may grow. 1 Peter 2:2, like newborn babies, long for the pure milk of the word, so that by it you may grow in respect to salvation. This is where you, brother and sister, are responsible to God for your efforts. Hide the word of God in your heart. Psalm 119:11, I have stored up your word in my heart that I might not sin against you. If there is a duty you have to God and to yourself, it is this: learn and study the Word of God. All words matter in the Scriptures. 2 Timothy 3:16, all Scripture is inspired by God and is useful for instruction, for conviction, for correction, and for training in righteousness. Can you see the error and deception of red letterism? Can you see the alignment with Islam's ignorance of the message of the gospel? Watching these delusions and deceptions all align and coalesce is fascinating. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.